Hi guys, welcome to the first video on the chapter Print Culture and the Modern World. We have divided this chapter into 8 topics. So in the first topic, we'll be discussing the first signs, the earliest signs of print. So print in these days, we know in a world where everything around us is printed. So we have books around us, we have magazines, newspapers, so printed material, pamphlets. So we are surrounded by the printed world right now. But in a few centuries ago, that wasn't the case. So the first sign of print was, instead of being in Western civilization, it was found in the Eastern civilization of China and Japan. So the print culture actually started in China, where the main method through which they started printing was the hand printing. So system of hand printing was developed in China, Japan and Korea. So how did they do this? They actually rubbed the paper against the inked surface of the wood blocks. So these wood blocks would be like this, where there would be ink and the paper would be rubbed on top, and hence the paper would get printed. But it could only be done on one side, hence the books were such a way that they were folded and stitched at the side. So this was the way through which the first books, the first printed papers were done in China. Then when the Chinese government started recruiting for various services, they had their exams, and for that they needed printed material. So that led to an increase in the printed material. So in the imperial state, the government was the biggest producer of printed material. Government system personnel recruited through civil services exams. So for that they had different textbooks as well, which were printed. These were sponsored by the government. Then from 16th century onwards, the number of examinations also included the increase, the candidates, and hence the printed material started increasing. So due to the fact that the government was involved in the expansion of the printed material, its pace actually increased quite significantly. So the volume of print actually increased in China. Now, not just for the various activities such as exams, what was actually happening is that the urban culture also led to the increase of the print culture. So these merchants, they started to collect trade information in printed material itself. Then reading also became a leisure activity, and people started reading for fun. So these rich women also began to read, which led to an increased exposure to reading material for the women as well. So the women also began to publish their poetry, plays. Then a lot of wives of scholar officials published their works. The courtesans also wrote about their life. So all in all, the women, especially the urban women, they started a culture where women started imposing on the print culture and started joining the bandwagon as well. So not just the government exams, the government's interference, also the role of the women also increased in the print culture. Now, the reading culture accompanied by new technology here. The Western printing techniques also came to China, and mechanical presses. So this increased the speed of printing. So what led to this is that there was increase in the production of books, newspapers, materials, magazines. So this made Shanghai, China, the hub of print culture because of new technologies, because of readership. So there was a demand, and now there was supply as well. Hence Shanghai became the hub of print culture. So not just in China, in Japan as well. In Japan, we had the Buddhist missionaries, and they were the one who actually introduced the print culture in Japan. So the oldest book is Diamond Sutra, which contains 6 sheets of text and woodcut illustrations. But mostly in Japan, the printing was done on textiles or on playing cards and paper money, but mostly on the textiles. So this was the one on which most of the printing was done. So these were very interesting practices because it was not done in the rest of the world. In the rest of the world, in fact, printing was done on paper itself, but here the printing was primarily done on textiles. Then poets and prose writers were regularly published in Japan. So there were a lot of folk stories on the Japanese culture which were published regularly. Now, paintings were also depicted on the urban culture. This involved the artisans, the courtesans and the tea house gatherings. So this was the uniqueness of the Japanese print culture, and the libraries and the bookstores were packed with hand printed material of various types. So here Japan in this sense was, even though it was similar to the development in China, but the interesting practices that were held in Japan that were unique only to Japan. So this made Japan's print culture a case study in itself. So these were the earliest signs of print in China and Japan. So this is all about the earliest signs. In the next video, we'll be discussing the coming of print to Europe. Thank you so much.